I was able to basically go from $500 to over about $6,000 a month just on YouTube, just because of these different things.
Pass up and change your life. You can have it all, no sacrifice. I know we did you wrong.
Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Money Mondays. So every single Monday on my Money Monday series, I basically talk about different financial related videos. I talk about a whole bunch of different things on this channel, you guys, from how to make money, how to save money, how to build credit, how to find different sources of income. And today's video is going to be how much I've made on YouTube altogether, as well as how you can increase your income. You guys know I'm always very transparent about you know, different things related to income. So I wanted to be talking about how much money I made through AdSense and how much money I make through promotions, and how you can figure out how much you should be charging as well. So definitely stay tuned, you guys. I might talk about a couple of different things on this video as well, anything that I deem will be interesting or informative for you guys. But if you guys are interested in this content, I don't want to make this intro too long, but I do want you guys to subscribe if you guys are interested in more financial related videos, and make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up before I start the video off. This is literally one of my most frequently asked questions. Anytime I tell somebody I'm a YouTuber, they always ask, oh, can you get paid? How much do you get paid? Stuff like that. And I always tell people that it definitely does vary. I'm going to talk about the different components that come into how much money you get paid from YouTube. If you guys are completely unfamiliar about you know, YouTube income and stuff like that, we do get paid as YouTubers. We get paid through Google just to run ads on our YouTube videos. So we get paid from something called Google AdSense. Google AdSense runs on a whole bunch of different platforms. YouTube is just one of them. So you can put ads on your blog, you can put ads on your website, and you will still get paid through Google AdSense. So that's just something that I feel like a lot of people don't know. That's one part of how we get paid through YouTube AdSense, and we get paid every 21st of the month for the previous month. So for example, this month on January 21st, I will get paid for how much money I made from December 1st to December 31st. And like I said before, there's a whole bunch of different components that come into how much money you get paid. Right now, I'm going to tell you guys how much I've made so far on YouTube. So since I've been on YouTube, I've uploaded 254 videos and I've been able to generate about 5.47 million views. All these videos and views combined, I have been able to make $67,000 on YouTube alone in the past 3 years, which is, I think, an amazing source of income, especially because my YouTube channel has just started to pick up since, I want to say, this summer. I've almost flipped my channel in the past, I want to say, 5 months or so. So just a quick background, you guys. I get paid through Google Ads. However, I do get paid for different promotions and stuff that I run on my YouTube videos. You guys will find, if you guys watch different videos like this, you guys will see that oftentimes people get paid a lot more from promotions than they do on their Google Ads, and that's because of a whole bunch of different reasons that I actually figured out recently. So there's a whole bunch of different components that go into how much money you make on ads. So you can have a small channel of only 21,000 subscribers, and you know, you can get paid more than somebody that has 200,000 subscribers just because of those different components. Price, the amount of money I make every single month, definitely varies a lot. As of this, I decided to create a whole bunch of different sources of income for myself so that I'm not relying only on my Google AdSense or my YouTube. And that's something I always recommend everybody to do, not to rely on just one source of income. If you guys need different ideas for side hustles, definitely check out my 15 side hustles video. That video ended up doing very, very well on this channel. The amount of money I make every single month had definitely ranged a lot. The reason why I say that YouTube is definitely passive income is because the more videos that you have on this platform, the more views is being generated, and the more money you're able to make every single month on ads. So with that being said, typically the longer that you're on YouTube, the more money you get every single month because you're making more videos that month. You know what I mean? So all the videos, for example, that I made in December, right, I have the ad revenue for that, along with all the views that I've gotten on all the other videos that I've made the previous years and months that I have on my channel. Now, so I'm going to talk about the different videos that I have on my channel and how much I've made from them so far to this date. So my most frequently watched video is my Money Mondays 15 Side Hustle Ideas to Make Up to $10,000 a Month in 2020. That video has 500,000 views. The video has made $4,000 already on my channel. Another video that I have on here. So my next highest viewed video has 455,000 views. And this video, This video was uploaded 2 years ago, and altogether I have made $6,000 off of this video. So $5,957. And even till this day, I can also check now that in the past 28 days, this video has made me $130. So that's actually pretty good for a video that was uploaded 2 years ago that probably took me about 2 hours to upload. I'm still making money to this day on that specific video. So that $130 adds to the amount of money I'm making this month on my channel. Veneers video, if you guys didn't know, I did get veneers. I uploaded, I filmed a video on the entire process and everything like that. I've made so far $3,585 on that video, and this month alone I've made $441, because obviously I'm still getting views on all of these videos. So I've made $441 this month on that video, and that video has less than 400,000 views. So that's another thing with YouTube, you really never know. Your video can really pick up at different times. I've had a couple of videos that, you know, weren't doing very well in the beginning. For example, my teeth video, it wasn't doing very well in the beginning because it was only being promoted to the people that I'm subscribed to, and my subscribers didn't really care about veneers. So they subscribed for a different type of content, so that was the content that they were looking for to see. However, YouTube definitely picked it up because the more people that are looking for that specific dentist, they're able to click on it, and I'm getting views consistently every single day on that video. So past 30 days, I've made $440 because I'm consistently getting views because people are constantly looking for reviews on that dentist. So something that I definitely did implement to increase the amount of money that I'm making per video towards the end of 2019 is adding more ads to the video. So as you guys can see on this video that you guys are watching right now, I'm gonna have multiple ads. YouTube typically only puts in one or two ads per video when you upload it yourself, right? And I honestly didn't know myself that I can place ads in the video as I want to. So I can put in 15 different ads if I want. So that's something that I definitely did take advantage of towards the end of the year, and that literally has changed the game. I'm making so much more money now than I was before just by adding more ads. Based on the type of videos that you create will dictate how much money or what kind of advertisement you guys will see played on the video. So a family channel that is more suitable for all ages will have a higher CPM than you know, a couple's channel, right, that do different pranks. I've seen crazy videos from different like relationship channels that do pranks, like Viagra pranks or you know, kissing pranks, something like anything that won't be suited for all different ages will have a lower CPM because it's not going to be suitable for all ages anymore. Right, another thing to note is your CPM. So your CPM is your cost per mil. So that's how much you are making per million views on your channel. So my CPM was definitely very low before, and that was due to a whole bunch of different reasons, due to my content, due to my geography. Another factor that's definitely a component onto how much money you're making per video is your CPM. I know if you guys have been doing research on YouTube, you guys have heard CPM several times before, but CPM is your cost per mil. So that means for every thousand, so if you have a $1 CPM and you get a million views, you'll get $1,000. I personally, my CPM ranges from $16 to about $22. So that means for a million views, I can get up to $16,000 to $22,000. Only thing is, there is a caveat, and YouTube does take half of your income, right? So the Google AdSense money that you will see on your account, you know, on the 21st, is already when Google has already taken half of your money. So the ad will generate $16,000 to $22,000. However, I will only be receiving $8,000 to $11,000. There are a whole bunch of different factors that come into why your CPM is low or very high. One is your location. So the United States, Canada, they all have very high CPMs. If you have a lot of viewership in like India or Pakistan, this is from me doing my own research, you'll have a much lower CPM because the ads that are going to be generated for that video are going to be different than the ads generated for, you know, a US or Canadian viewer. So it really does come down to whose ads are playing on your videos, right? And your CPM will definitely change also based on the type of content that you post. If your YouTube videos are suitable for all ages, you'll get a little bit more money than somebody that's, you know, YouTube videos are only for, you know, adults or people that are over 18. So another thing that does take into account to how much money you're going to be making per video is how long people are watching. Obviously, if they're only going to get through the first ad and they're not getting to the second and third ad on your channel, it doesn't matter how many ads you post, they're just not going to get to those ads. So the amount of time people are watching your video definitely does take into effect, as well as how long your video is. A lot of people don't realize this, but if you have less than 10 minutes of footage and you post a video on YouTube, you're not going to be able to put multiple ads in. So another tip is to make sure that all of your videos are over 10 minutes so that you can put multiple ads in the video and have more potential to reach higher ad clicks. The more videos you post, the more views you're getting on a monthly basis, so the more you're going to be getting paid every single month. I was able to basically go from $500 to over about $6,000 a month just on YouTube, just because of these different things. So another huge component of your YouTube income is your promotions and collaborations. How much you are getting for different brand deals that you have, different sponsorships that you're doing on your channel. And there's a whole bunch of different ways to figure out how much you should be charging. And, you know, people go about it different ways. I created my own kind of like, equation to figure out how much I should charge for collaborations and things like that. So you get the average of your past 6 video views, and based on where that number falls, you can charge $500 per 10,000 views. Okay, so that means if you have 20,000 views, you can charge $1,000, and so on and so forth. Basically, depending on the specific brand, if you feel as though they have more money to spend, you can charge more. If you feel like it's a small company, you can obviously charge less. But that's kind of like the roundabout how much I charge per video. So my price right now for brand deals are definitely a lot higher now, because I can guarantee more views than I did back last January of 2019. So that's one thing. And then you can use that equation, or you can go on your social blue book. And this is kind of like a roundabout how much you should be able to charge. I'm gonna actually screenshot this so that I can put it on the screen here. What I like about social blue book is that you can change it for a dedicated upload, a shout out, or a direct link. The difference between a dedicated upload, a shout out, and stuff like that is that a dedicated video means that you only have one sponsor and you're talking about that sponsor for the entire video. I typically don't do videos like that because I don't feel as though it gives as much content, so I prefer doing shout outs. So for a shout out, based on the specific company that you're working with, some require 3 minutes of a shout out, some require 2 minutes of a shout out, and the prices definitely do vary. With Social Blue Book, I see that this price is definitely a lot lower than I would typically do for a shout out, and that's only because they're using my views per video for my entire channel instead of doing my past 6 videos. For my entire channel, it's not very accurate because they're including videos that I uploaded, you know, when I first started my channel a couple of years ago, and I was only getting 1,000 views per video, right? My past 6 videos now, you can see that I'm getting a lot more video, getting a lot more views. I have videos that have, you know, 50,000 views, 200,000 views. One of my past 6 videos has 500,000 views, so obviously I can guarantee higher viewage on, viewage is not a word, but I can guarantee higher views on my upcoming video that I will be working with the sponsorship because of the rate that I had at my previous videos, right? So this is just another way to kind of check. I typically I use this a lot when I was first starting out, but that's because I had less videos to kind of include in here. Because there's so many different videos that is included in this, you know, kind of algorithm that they created, it's not very accurate at this point, right? So you guys will see here that the low for this is $256 and the high is $877. The suggested price is $567. I charge a lot higher than this. My own kind of formula now to generate my promotion price, but this is just another way you guys can check on your own. And you can just log in, create an account through Social Blue Book, and you guys will be able to figure out how much you can charge yourself. Besides YouTube, besides Google AdSense, besides you know, promotions and collaborations, I do have a lot of different incomes that has definitely stemmed off of my YouTube channel. And I mentioned this in my how I was able to make $100,000 at only 21 years old video. I kind of talked about how YouTube has paved the way for me to create a couple of businesses, for me to get affiliate marketing income. I now do speaking engagements at different universities. If you guys do want me to speak as a keynote at your upcoming event or something like that, definitely email me. I love speaking at different universities. You guys can check out my website, lavishruby.com/speaking engagements or something like that, or speaking. I'll put the link on the screen here, but you guys can see all of my past speaking engagements for 2019, and those are all paid speaking engagements. A couple of them, I want to say 95% of them are all speaking, 95% of them are paid speaking engagements. So that's a whole other source of income that I have now because I have such a huge audience like my YouTube channel. So definitely you guys take advantage of YouTube. YouTube is a great source of income, especially if you're doing it the right way. I wasn't putting enough ads. I wasn't uploading a lot. I think I uploaded maybe 2 videos that entire month. All that does affect how much I made. However, I had other sources of income that allowed me to stay afloat. So I did, I did 2 promotions that month on YouTube, 1 on Instagram, that all made more than my actual $500 Google AdSense income. And then I had a speaking engagement. I think I had 2 speaking engagements that month. I also was selling my Lavish Life academic planners. I had a lot of different sources of income that month that was able to generate me a lot more income than I would have saw if I just had my Google AdSense. So definitely you guys, make sure you guys take all of that into account. If you guys are interested on videos to grow your YouTube channel, to see how I was able to grow my YouTube channel these past couple of months to definitely get a lot more views than I was previously, definitely comment that down below and I'll do a YouTube growth tips video. But that's basically it for this episode of Money Mondays. If you guys want to see more videos like this, definitely comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.